This is going to be a jam-packed video. We're going to cover PIR sensors, radar sensors, do a bit of image processing, and we'll stray into face detection and recognition. I could have made 5 or 6 videos, but I like you all so much, I'm going to smash it all into one bumper video. If you follow the channel, you'll know I've got a magic mirror. And if you don't follow the channel, what's wrong with you? Hit the subscribe button, like this video, and leave a funny comment. So, I love my magic mirror, but I've got a big problem with it. There's nothing wrong with it functionally, it does everything I need. The problem I have is always on and it's always drawing maximum power. It's not a lot of power, but have you seen the cost of electricity lately? I want to fix this problem, but what can I do? If this was a desktop or laptop, then we'd just have it turn off the screen after a period of inactivity. Pretty simple when you have a mouse or keyboard, but a magic mirror with a mouse and keyboard would look pretty silly. We could add a button, we could even try and get clever and add a capacitive touch sensor, maybe in the frame or behind the glass, but then we'd end up with mucky fingerprints all over the mirror, and it kind of defeats the whole point of having a magic mirror in the first place. I might as well just use my phone. What we really want to do is to only have the screen turn on if someone is actually in front of the mirror. So what can we do? Well, the obvious solution is to just have a motion sensor. It's not a bad idea, so we'll look at that first. We've got a couple of options. We'll start off with the old classic passive infrared motion sensor. These are readily available and are dead easy to hook up. There's only 3 pins to worry about: power, ground, and the output pin. The power pin can take anything between 4.5 and 12 volts, so that's easy enough, we can just take 5 volts directly from the Pi. The output pin goes high if movement is detected, so that's also pretty simple. There's a couple of potentiometers for tuning the behaviour, one of them adjusts the sensitivity and the other adjusts how long the output pin stays high for when the motion is detected. The only slightly confusing option is this jumper. This switches the board between re-trigger or normal mode. In re-trigger mode, the pin goes high when motion is detected and will go low after the delay from the time from the last motion was detected. Basically, the pin will stay high for as long as something is moving. In normal mode, the output will trigger every second or so when there is motion. You'll typically be wanting to use re-trigger mode, as this behaves in the most sensible way that most people would expect. I've hooked it up to an LED and it lights up when there's movement. Pretty simple. So we could easily connect this to our Raspberry Pi. But I can hear a few of you shouting, "Stop! You're about to connect a 5V output to the 3.3V input of the Raspberry Pi. Don't you realise how bad that could be and how precious your Raspberry Pi is?" Well, worry not. These boards have a cheeky 3.3V regulator on them, so they are actually running at 3.3V logic levels. You can in fact bypass this regulator if you only have 3.3V available to you. So we can just hook it straight up to the Pi without any worries, and it works pretty well. The problem I have with this module is it's pretty thick. If we stick this behind the mirror, then it's going to stick out from the wall. I'm also not even sure that it will work through the mirror. It's entirely possible that the mirror will block any infrared light, and if we put it outside of the mirror, it's going to look pretty ugly. So let's have a look at something slightly more modern. I've had this Doppler Radar Microwave Motion Sensor module lying around for ages. The nice thing about this module is it's pretty much a drop-in replacement for the PIR module. It can take 4 volts to 28 volts on its VIN pin, and it also has a 3.3 volt compatible output. There's even a 3.3 volt regulated supply that you can use to power other low current devices. It will do around 100 milliamps or so. The other really nice thing is that it's super slim, so it will fit behind the mirror quite nicely. These are really very clever devices. They use a PCB antenna to send out microwaves at around 3.18 GHz, and it measures the radiation that is reflected back. They are also dead cheap. On AliExpress, you can get them for just over 20 pence each. That's less than half the price of a PIR sensor. Now, there are much more sophisticated Doppler radar sensors. Great Scott did a really good recent video where he built a really nice alarm system using a human presence radar sensor module. But this module is 10 times more expensive than the cheap board I am using. I've hooked up my module to a Raspberry Pi and stuck it behind the mirror. Let's see if it actually works. I was actually quite worried that the half-silvered mirror might block the radar, but it seems to work fine. If anything, it might be too good. We may get a lot of false positives from people moving around in the rest of the house. This is a problem. We really only want to power things up if there's definitely someone in front of the mirror. Since we're looking at PCBs, it's a good time to slip in a mention of PCBWay, who are sponsoring this video. They've got their 9th anniversary going on right now, so there's a bunch of money off coupons. If you need a PCB, then pop over to PCB Way. They're really great and do a great service. So let's get a bit more sophisticated. How about using a camera attached to the Pi? This might give us some really interesting options. We should be able to use the camera to detect motion. And if we get clever, we should be able to actually detect if someone is looking at the mirror. As a stretch goal, we could even potentially recognise who the person is. That would be really cool. Let's cover the motion detection option first. This is actually really trivial to do with a camera. All you need to do is compare the latest frame from the camera with the previous frame and see if they are different. The easiest way to do this is to take the absolute difference between each frame. You can then threshold this to remove any noise, and then it's just a case of counting how many pixels have changed. If there's a lot of changed pixels, then there must have been some movement in front of the camera. It's dead simple, and it works pretty well. Here I am moving around in front of the Pi. What about face detection? We've got the camera anyway, so we might as well go to town. What are our options? Well, we have OpenCV. This runs pretty well on the Pi Zero. They have a HAAR cascade classifier already trained for detecting faces, so we just need to download this. The code is really simple, it's just a few lines. I've got it set up and running in a loop. It's really fast, and it only takes around 50 to 100 milliseconds per frame. That's pretty amazing, not bad for a Pi Zero 2. So that's face detection. What about our stretch goal of face recognition? Mirror, mirror on the wall, who am I? Well, I've found another Python library, aptly named Face Recognition. This is built on top of the really cool dlib library. The dlib library has state-of-the-art face recognition built in. So not only can we detect a face, we should be able to identify who the face belongs to. That's magic! All you need to do is provide the code with pictures of each face you want to recognise. It detects the location of the face and then matches the detected face against the known faces. The only downside is this library is quite a bit slower than the OpenCV version and takes around 0.85 seconds to run the face detection. If there is a face in the frame, then it takes an additional 0.7 seconds to do the face recognition. But it feels like we could get the best of both worlds. We could use the OpenCV face detection and then use this face recognition library for doing the actual face recognition. The only problem with all this clever stuff is that running the camera and doing image processing is pretty intensive, and it maxes out the CPU. When the Pi is idling along doing nothing, then it draws around 100 milliamps. If we run the camera and motion detection code, this goes up to over 200 milliamps. And when we're running the face detection code, it goes up to over 300 milliamps. This kind of goes against our original goal of trying to reduce power consumption. The Pi and camera also starts to get quite warm when we run them continuously. We can see this by looking at it with my infrared camera. I have to say, I absolutely love this gadget. It was quite expensive, but it's now one of my favourite toys. So why not combine everything together in one awesome package? We'll use the radar detector to see if anyone is near the mirror. If there is, then we'll use the camera to detect if there's motion in front of the mirror. And then we'll use the OpenCV face detection code to see if there's a face in front of it. And finally, only if there's a face present, we'll power on the screen. We'll kick off the face recognition as a background job to see who the person is. We want to have anonymous access to the mirror so we can show it off to any visitors. I'll use this very simple state machine to control all of this. We'll start off in idle mode, waiting for the radar detector to fire. We can do this in a really power-efficient way using interrupts. When the motion sensor fires, we'll switch into movement detection mode. This will run the camera along with our simple motion detection algorithm. If there's movement, then we'll switch into face acquisition mode. This will run the OpenCV face detection code at full speed. If we detect a face, we'll switch into active mode. This will power on the screen and try to recognise who the face belongs to. We'll then just grab a frame every second and use the OpenCV code to make sure there's still someone looking at the mirror. If we don't see a face for more than 5 seconds and the motion detector says there's no motion, we'll power off the screen and drop back into idle mode. So does it actually work? Well, as with most things, the answer is a qualified yes. I've hooked up the camera and I'm running my simple state machine. In idle mode, the screen is off. We walk near the mirror and detect motion with the radar sensor. And then we confirm the movement with the camera and detect the face. The screen turns on and we even manage to recognise the face. That's pretty amazing. It does work. When we walk away, the screen eventually turns off. So are we actually saving any power? I've hooked up my USB power meter and used it to trigger the 12 volts needed by the mirror. We can see that in idle mode, we are just using around 150 milliamps. When we switch the camera on and start image processing, we go up to around 350 milliamps. And then, when the screen powers up, we hit almost 700 milliamps. When we drop back into idle mode, the current consumption goes down to about 400 milliamps. And then the screen briefly wakes up and then goes into standby mode. Once the screen is in standby mode, we drop back down to around 150 milliamps. So that's pretty good. We've gone from around 600 milliamps all the time, down to around 150 milliamps most of the time. So we're running at about 25% the original power consumption. Not bad at all. But as I said, it's a qualified yes. There are some issues. The camera is behind the half-silvered mirror, so a lot of the light is being blocked. The image processing all works on a bright day, but it struggles quite a bit at night, even with all the lights turned on. We could install a motion-activated light, or we could use infrared LEDs to illuminate the face and use the camera with no IR filter, but this seems slightly over the top. There's also an issue with how long the screen takes to turn on. It takes around 1 or 2 seconds for the screen to wake up from standby mode. This is pretty quick, but it is noticeable. So at the moment, my feeling is the full system is not quite ready for production. So I'm just going to use the motion sensor while I work on improving it. All in all though, a pretty interesting project. Let me know what you think in the comments. And since you're here, why not check out the original Magic Mirror video? It's pretty interesting.